from Nashville and from what is arguably the most famous stage and spotlight in American music, the Grand Ole Opry. Since 1925, its members have included the best of country music, from Patsy Cline and Johnny Cash to Loretta Lynn and Dolly Parton. They've all made country the soundtrack of America, played now on more radio stations in the U.S. than any other kind of music. And joining those legendary ranks as a recent inductee to the Opry, a young woman who just a few years ago was singing in her high school choir in rural Oklahoma. Today, she's a worldwide superstar, Carrie Underwood. I ain't in Chicago anymore.
Great.
Her resume reads like a Hall of Famers who's been working in the industry for decades. Over 10 million CDs sold, a record-breaking 10 number one singles, including Jesus Take the Wheel. Jesus Take the Wheel, take it from my hand. I dug my key into the side of this pretty little souped-up four-wheel drive. And the song that has become an anthem for any woman worried her man may have a roving eye. The smash hit, Before He Cheats. And then there's the awards.
Carrie Underwood.
4 Grammys, 8 Academy of Country Music Awards.
It's Carrie Underwood.
Carrie Underwood.
And 5 CMAs.
Carrie Underwood.
Thank you so much.
And did I mention she is still only 26 years old? Hard to believe that just a few years ago, a very nervous Carrie Underwood was literally singing for her survival in the audition of a lifetime.
You can make your heart.
The voice is there.
Something that it won't hear in the dark.
Okay, that was very good.
When you were waiting to go in, what was going through your mind?
Don't get sick and
don't get sick.
Do your thing. Oh, just the nerves.
Carrie had wowed the judges.
Yes.
Carrie, you're through to the next round.
Welcome to Hollywood, girl.
And here you are to get on a plane by yourself and go to Hollywood.
Yeah. I've never been in an airport before, and it's amazing that I made it there. I was horrified, and my dad, on the way to the airport, I was about to cry, and he said, you know, if you want to go home, we can go home and you don't ever have to think about this ever again. And I was like, oh, but I will think about it. So I have to.
Carrie Underwood!
This crowning moment drew over 30 million viewers. Just a few months later, her first CD, Some Hearts, skyrocketed to number one, selling over 7 million copies. American Idol had delivered a bona fide superstar, and the first with a decidedly country flavor. Nobody was cheering louder than the 3,500 residents of her beloved hometown of Shakota, Oklahoma, a farm town with one stoplight, a local diner, and nearby Lake Eufaula with its magical sunsets. I met up with Carrie in Shakota.
How has it changed?
The town?
Yes, in recent years.
There are things that are different. We got another stoplight. We got a new Walmart. We got a new stoplight because of the new Walmart.
As Carrie was showing me around town, we came upon Fast Lanes Bowling, the site of her after-prom party. She challenged me to a match.
I'm objecting right now. She has her own bowling shoes. She travels with her own shoes, so foul.
No wonder the girl with a golden touch took one step up to the lane and...
if I can talk to you now if you beat me in bowling.
But was the girl who's come so far, so fast, ready for the intense scrutiny that comes with fame?
How can anybody be prepared for being in the spotlight and people wanting to know everything about you?
That was a big wake-up call because it's hard to, like, deal with the notion that you don't know any of these people, but they all know you.
Even as far back as elementary school, as this never-before-seen video shows, the audiences all knew she had the voice.
Someone's thinking of
and 11-year-old Carrie singing in Hebrew at a choir concert. But most often, she sang country.
Moldy, you're just the same as I did yesterday.
And then there were the beauty pageants. This video we uncovered shows Carrie competing in the 2002 and 2003 Miss Northeastern State University pageants. She was runner-up 2 years strong.
Carrie Marie Underwood.
Whoa!
After winning Idol, just as her career started to take off, she surprised many people by going back to college in Oklahoma to finish her degree in broadcasting. With the degree and the Idol title came romance, and never far behind, headlines. Carrie dated Dallas Cowboys quarterback Tony Romo for 2 months before they broke up and he began dating Jessica Simpson. The tabloids had a field day, alleging catfights and feuds between Jessica and Carrie, who says those rumors are all untrue.
Is it difficult to have a romantic life being in the spotlight?
It's difficult when people make their own assumptions about things. I assume it's known that I do have a boyfriend.
Her boyfriend of almost a year is Ottawa Senators hockey player Mike Fisher.
We went to a concert together, and he left at one point to go see our friend play, like, down the street. And people Twittered and stuff like that we had a fight in the middle of the concert, and he left. And we broke up. I'm like, whoa, it's, like, so far from what actually happened. So that part's really hard to deal with.
But you all have stayed under the radar. You're two very high profile. He's a heck of a hockey player, by the way. I'm a big hockey fan. Yeah, he's very good. Mike's great. But how have you been able to stay just below the radar?
We stay in, you know, we're not like big party goers, so we don't show up to events together and things like that. And other than that, you know, if anybody ever asks about personal, private, you know, things, it's always just, I'm just really happy. And that's kind of where I leave it. Like, I'm a happy person in every aspect of my life, including that one.
Do you have a timeline with you thinking about marriage and kids?
Oh, gosh. As far as a timeline now, it really just depends on what God has planned. You know, it's not, I can try to make my own plans. I've been doing that my whole life, and it's never worked out, so I don't know why I'd start now.
Carrie's other great passion is finding time to give back. Last month, we were there when she lit up the Grand Ole Opry pink for breast cancer awareness. That's Cowboy Casanova, the number one smash hit off her new CD, Play On.
You're taking more of a role in writing a number of the songs. So how do you go about selecting what's going to be on an album?
It's really important to me to have as much on there as I possibly can and still make it all make sense. Even if it's, you know, just kind of a little thread running through all of it. It's sassy.
He's a good time, Cowboy Casanova.
Sassy is right. In her new video for Cowboy Casanova, Carrie pushes the envelope of her wholesome image to the brink.
Video finally came out. My parents saw it, and I said, "Really, you like it?" And I was like, "You didn't think the clothes were, you know, too little, right?" And she was like, "Oh no, it just looked great. You just look so great." And I was like, "What'd Daddy think?" And she asked him, and he was good with everything. And I said, "He's not going to disown me, is he? He's not, like, you know, embarrassed to watch it." And he said, "No." So they were both proud.
So you got the two thumbs up from Dad.
Yes, two thumbs up from Mom and Dad.
You better run for your life.
And from the millions of fans who made this small town girl their big country idol.
Thank you.
I want a rematch with Carrie at the bowling alley. But tomorrow night, Carrie will join Brad Paisley here on ABC as co-host of the 43rd annual CMA Awards, where she's nominated for two honors, including Female Vocalist of the Year.